Hello fellow wine lovers, welcome back to my channel. So today we're gonna talk about the top best white wines of Italy. Italy is normally famous for its red wines, or normally more famous for its red wines, but in Italy there are also very very good white wines that I really want to show you, and I really hope you have the chance to try this lovely example. So we will go through a few wine producers and wines from this lovely country that in my opinion you must try absolutely as soon as possible, and that you can find in the market right now, of course. And you can find the link for some of these wines in the description below. There is a link where you can source this wine from all over the world. So before we start, I just want to mention that I didn't put this in a order that in my opinion this is the best, this is the less best, okay? So the order is a random order, okay? So I just wanted to have to put an order, but this doesn't mean anything that this one is best, better than this one, or vice versa, okay? So it is purely in order for video purposes, but not for quality purposes, okay? So the first wine I want to mention is Vintage Tunina by Yerman. Vintage Tunina is one of my favorite white wine of Italy that comes from the northeast part of Italy, and it is a unique blend of four grapes variety. You have Sauvignon Blanc, Chardonnay, Ribolla Gialla, that is an indigenous grape of this area, and Malvasia as well, indigenous from this area, around this area. Okay, and so Sauvignon Blanc, Chardonnay are 50%, 60% of the blend, basically, plus these two indigenous grapes. It is unoaked, really important, and it is extremely, extremely elegant and creamy. It is like an explosion of flowersy note, like a very subtle note of white flowers and yellow flowers, a little bit of also fruit, stone fruit, and it is very very elegant and long in the palate with a lovely and nice crispness. I do normally suggest and pair this wine with the seafood, of course, like crustaceous works very very well, also shellfish works extremely well, but also all the white fish in general, but also as aperitif by itself. So Yerman is one of the top producers that we are going now to jump and see in a full screen. So Yerman is really really beautiful. It is one of the best and most regarded white wine producers that you can find in the market. It also produce a lot of varietal grape, and here you can see a little bit of the story of this lovely wine. So Vintage Tunina is a bright straw colored with golden reflection. The nose is intense, wide, very elegant and persistent, with scents of honey and country flowers. As I said, it is dry, of course, soft, and well balanced, with an extraordinary persistence due to its full body. I would say medium to full body. It match, of course, they say, with truffles, with fish dishes, and poultry also. I do have to agree. Salmon, they suggest, also Parmesan cheese and artichoke. So the first vintage, it is date back on 73, but was first released in 75, so there is a little bit of experience behind this wine. It is harvested, of course, by hand. There are 16 hectares cultivated in the vineyards of Yerman dedicated to this wine, and Vintage Tunina was a nickname for Antonia, that who is the wine dedicated to. So it is well rewarded from some wine expert, Italian wine expert, but not only. And it is really an exceptional wine that you should try. A little bit of Yerman, Vintage Tunina is of course their probably best, but they also produce 100% Ribolla Gialla, for instance, that I do recommend to try. It is situated in the Friuli Venezia Giulia, beautiful region, focused on white wine productions. And there is a beautiful landscape, of course. And so I really do recommend you to try this wine. It is worth. The following wine I want to talk about now is called Poggio alle Gazze, by Tenuta dell'Ornellaia. So we are in central Italy, we are in Tuscany. Ornellaia is very, very famous for its reds, the Merlot base blend, Masseto, for instance, and Tenuta dell'Ornellaia, of course, Bordeaux blend in Bulgari. But they produce also beautiful, beautiful white wines. And this specifically one, Poggio alle Gazze, is based of Sauvignon, mainly 75-78%. Vermentino, that is an indigenous grape of this area, and a little bit of Verdicchio. It makes a wine that is extremely elegant, fresh and creamy, with these lovely flowery notes, aromatic herbs like a little bit of rosemary, a little bit of sage as well in the nose, and a little bit of also fruit, stone fruit. And in the palate is really, really minerally crispy and creamy in the same time. So that's why I love this wine. As Vintage Tunina, the balance is the key. They are really, really elegant white wines, and fresh and of course dry. But let's jump now. Let's see now a little bit more about this Poggio alle Gazze. Is an elegant Mediterranean style of this estate, unique microclimate. The gift of nature allows Poggio alle Gazze dell'Ornellaia with a predominance of Sauvignon Blanc. And if you are interested in Sauvignon Blanc, you must watch the video about Sauvignon Blanc that you can find here in the description below, to display a firm structure and ripe fruit while maintaining great finesse. And I absolutely agree regarding this point. Here the blend, as you can see, Sauvignon Blanc, Vermentino and Verdicchio. It is hand-picked, of course. The grapes are hand-picked in early morning to preserve the acidity, and they are immediately chilled and crushed to preserve the aromatic compound. And then it goes through a little bit of course, aging in barrique to separate a lot the grapes are vinified and aged partially in new and used barrique and in stainless steel tanks and in concrete vats. So they are basically partially aged in wood and partially aged in stainless steel. And then the wine is matured on fine lees for 6 months with regular batonnage. Batonnage is where they are stirring basically the lees throughout the wine. And so after the light fine, it is rested an additional 12 months in the bottle before release. So it is really, really an expression of also a lot of winemaking work behind. Let's see a little bit the tasting notes that the Olga Fusari, the winemaker, says. Aromatic expression of white wines, has a bright straw yellow color with green reflection. On the nose, it releases intense notes of citrus and exotic fruits, accompanied with a scent of mowed grass and asparagus that comes from the Sauvignon Blanc. And on the palate is a full body and vibrant, characteristic by a vibrant acidity and mineral and lingering finish. And I absolutely agree, it is really, really mind blowing. I do normally pair this one as well with the fish, rich fish, but also with the pastas. all the seafood pasta and even veggie pasta, but it can go also well with light meat like chicken. Absolutely no problems at all. So I really hope you have the chance to try this Poggio alle Gazze by Ornellaia. If you are enjoying the channel and the video, I hope I get a subscription for you, and if this is not the case, please subscribe to my channel right now. This will help me a lot in making more video and will support me a lot also, and also help you can get and smash the like and subscribe. Click the notification bell so you won't miss any new video coming out. So what is this channel about? This channel is about you, first of all. I want to give you the best information, the best recommendation from a professional sommelier. I studied in Italy and in the UK in a very prestigious school, so I want to give a little bit of my knowledge back to you all. So if this is the channel you are looking for, where you can find the hidden wine gems from around the world, the best expression, also the wine that you must try once in a lifetime, but also the one more affordable that are really, really good in value and quality, so this is the channel I hope for you. If this is the case, subscribe and smash the like button. Thank you very much. So the following wine, I believe, is one of the best Italian white wines that you must try once in a lifetime, is Cervaro della Sala by Antinori. It is and it was one of the first Italian Chardonnay to made in a Burgundy style, so with age in the wooden barrel and with a little bit of lees aging as well. And Antinori is one of the most famous Italian wine producers, more famous for the red, but he has been able in Umbria to basically find the right spot to grow Chardonnay with the Grechetto, that is an indigenous grape that comes from Umbria. So he basically made a blend of mainly Chardonnay with a little bit of Grechetto to give a little bit of creaminess and minerality. And the Cervaro della Sala is beautiful. It is really an expression of the Italian Chardonnay with, we can see here a lot of tropical fruits on the nose, a lot of complexity, and we can read a little bit over. So the name Cervaro comes from the noble family that owned the Castello della Sala during the 14th century, bought by the Antinori brand. A blend of Chardonnay grapes with a small quantity of Grechetto that might change vintage by vintage, and they can go over time and represent an elegance and complexity of this unique estate. Cervaro della Sala is one of the first Italian white wines to have malolactic fermentation and aging take place in barriques, as in Burgundy, okay? So made in a Burgundy style. The first vintage of Cervaro to be produced was in the 85. So as we can see here, the barrique is one of the first to be aged in barrique, so to get a little bit of white spices and a little bit of buttery notes due to the malolactic fermentation that happens. And what we can say, it is really beautiful. You have also these here you can see these the castle and the vineyards around the castle in Umbria. Go to visit if you can, whenever we will be able to travel again. And I really want to go. I haven't been yet to this specific estate, so it is in my wishing list. And so it is a perfect place for growing white varieties. The vines grow in clay with calcareous-based soil, rich in fossil shells, and they were exposed to the rising of the sun with an excellent difference on temperature between day and night, because we are around, I would say, 200 and 400 meters from sea level, so there is a good variation in temperature between day and night. So a lot of minerality, a lot of tropical fruit also in the nose, a little bit of white flowers and also yellow flowers, super elegant, super well balanced, creamy, And it goes perfectly well with, I would say, the truffles. I do love this wine with black truffle and also white truffles and all the pastas in general with the seafood. In my opinion, this is super. But also can go well with the light meat. So I hope you have the chance to try this masterpiece of Italian Chardonnay. The next wine I want to talk about is made and produced by Roagna, and it is called Solea Roagna, and it is a blend again of Chardonnay with a little bit of Nebbiolo vinified in white. We are in north of Italy, we are in Piedmont, and this is probably one of the best white wine ever produced in Italy. And Roagna is very famous also for the Barolos that they make in there, and but it makes also this beautiful white wine that is based on Chardonnay. Super elegant, super creamy as well, a little bit bolder than the previous one, because the Nebbiolo gives that extra touch of acidity and boldness to the wine, so that give a little bit of structure to this wine. Super elegant. As I said, it is made and produced inside the Barolo area from a famous vineyard that we're gonna see very shortly. Let's read a little bit about this lovely wine. Our vineyard sits on the side of Serralunga d'Alba, so we are on the east part of Barolo area, and Perno, southeast facing, so we get the light from the morning till early afternoon. Pira is the name of the vineyard that produced Nebbiolo and Chardonnay, located in the rocks of Castiglione. Solea is sourced from the bottom section of the Pira vineyard, using Chardonnay vines that are approximately 30 years old. Additionally, there is a percentage of Nebbiolo added to this white blend. Harvest takes place in September, usually when the fruit, the grape, has reached perfect physiological maturity. Then it is, of course, hand harvested. Fermentation lasts about 10 days and takes place exclusively in large wood cask, thanks to the pied de cut created from our indigenous yeast. The wine is then aged in a neutral oak barrel for about 2 years. So even here there are some white spices. There is also lees contact. And instead of using small barriques, here they use big barrels, okay? Old barrels also. So they don't, I would say, offset, and it is not overwhelmingly felt in the wine. So it is very, very elegant and very, very well balanced. So let's see now a little bit of the story of this vineyard that is beautiful. So as you can see, here is the place in the Lange that is amazingly beautiful. This is the village nearby, and this is the vineyard, absolutely outstanding, with southeast disposition. So you see on the south, bottom there is the Chardonnay, and on top instead we have the Nebbiolo. So here they also produce Barolo, and they are able to source and to ripe well the Chardonnay too, with old vines, average of 30 years, so extremely rich and grapes. And what else can we say? It is absolutely beautiful. The Roagna is one of the best producers of this area. So I hope you enjoyed the video. I hope you found new wine gems, maybe that you didn't know, or maybe that I put on your wishing list to try. So these can be some alternatives to the most famous, maybe Burgundy wines. Especially if you are a Chardonnay lover, you should try also all these Chardonnay base, especially the Solea and the Cervara. Instead, if you are more, I would say, a Sauvignon lover, you should try the Vintage Tonina and the Poggio Alleazze Absoluti. So these are big names, quite big names in Italy, in the Italian panorama. Some of them are a little bit expensive, but some of them are also affordable. Anyway, they are not, they don't have crazy prices, okay? So I hope you have the chance to try, and I'm very curious to know if you have tried some of these wines, and if it is yes, let me know in the description below which one did you try and what do you think about that specific wine. If not, which one would you like to try? So leave in the description below your comments and share with the YouTube community your opinion. It will be greatly appreciated. So I hope you enjoyed this video. If this is the case, don't forget to subscribe to my channel so you won't miss any new video coming out. Smash the like button and click the notification bell. So I hope to see you on the next video, and until then, ciao!